Welcome, grandparents and guests. We are so excited to have you here for our special Grandparents' Day performance. Let's open with a word of prayer. Dear Lord, thank you for this day. Thank you for our amazing grandparents and for the special school, Denver Christian. We pray that our grandparents feel loved and blessed today and that they know how much they mean to us. Thank you for this time. We pray all of these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
At Denver Christian, we are grateful for so many things. For our families, our friends, our schools, our churches, and our freedom. Living in America is something we don't take for granted. Today we thought we could honor our grandparents by celebrating our freedom and gratitude.
Recently, we honored veterans with a special program, and we would like to share some of those songs with you today. Our first song is called Thank a Vet, followed by On Veterans Day.
When the Declaration of Independence was signed on July 4, 1776, America was born.
When the Declaration of Independence states principles on which our government and our identity as Americans are based.
We hold these truths.
Abraham Lincoln called it a rebuke and a stumbling block to tyranny and oppression. The Declaration of Independence continues to inspire people around the world today.
We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their Creator with certain unalienable rights. Among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness.
November is the month to be thankful for. When you're remembering all the things you have to be thankful for, veterans should be at the top of that list.
This is true. They've been keeping us safe in the past and are still keeping us safe right now.
Also at the top of that list should be our grandparents. I mean, let's face it, without you, we would not exist.
One of the reasons we want to say thank you is because you had to raise our mom and dad.
Yikes, that must have been tough. But I think my parents turned out pretty okay. So thank you for being great examples.
We would now like to share some letters with you that we wrote to some of our grandparents.
Dear Grandma, I want to thank you for all the amazing times we have spent together, even though it's not a lot since you live in another country. And I just want you to know that I really love you for all the things you do. I look forward to every holiday because you are so kind and send big boxes of goodies. I love seeing you this year and being able to go shopping with you. I hope you have a wonderful Thanksgiving and Merry Christmas. Love, Aiko.
Dear Grandpa and Grandma, thank you for all the wonderful and fun things you do for me. I love when Grandma makes chocolate chip cookies and pancakes and also pecan pie. I have a lot of fun playing cards and board games with my grandma also. I enjoy Fridays when Grandpa gets me a special dinner. And I have fun working on the tractor and four-wheeler with Grandpa. I also love riding on the tractor and four-wheeler with him. Thank you both for coming to my sports games and school events. Your support makes me happy, and I feel more confident. Love, Tyson.
Dear Grandma and Grandpa, thank you for being there for me and supporting me when I have hard moments. Thanks for coming to see some of my events at school and for supporting my dad at his races. Thanks for making it fun every time we go to your house. I love the time when we went to Cancun together when I was 7. I love being on the beach with you, and I will never forget when the sea was shining. I love you both so much, and I can't wait to see you for Christmas. Happy Grandparents' Day. Love, Madison.
Dear Grandma and Grandpa, my mom told me that when I was born, you were the first people I met after her and my dad. Ever since, you have been with me in all the biggest moments of my life. You are the best grandparents ever because you help with everything from sewing and cross-stitching to bow and arrow and sports. I hope you know that I love you so much, and I am so thankful to have you as my grandparents, even though you don't let us put up the Christmas tree till after Thanksgiving. You are so helpful when it comes to school and friends. You are funny when you need to be and serious when you should be. You are good at spoiling us, and you might want to keep that up. Some people think it's boring to hear all the names in the Bible, generation after generation after generation. But that shows just how important the crazy names are in all the family lines and trees. Because if we didn't have those family lines and trees, it would become confusing, and we would not know who our grandparents are. That is why you are the best grandparents ever.
Dear Grandma, thank you for always watching me when it's hard to get to our house with the weather. Thank you for supporting me in a lot of things I do. We're always together for the holidays, and I look forward to this every year. I know this year will be different because Grandpa has now passed, but we still have him in our hearts, wherever we go. I love all the Sundays that you and Grandpa could come over, and then all the Wednesdays and Saturday we got to visit him at the village. One of my favorite memories is when Grandpa would tell us pirate jokes and then we would hunt for treasure during our family reunions. I also love visiting the lake by your house to kayak, swim, and dig in the sand. With all these memories, it still feels like he is here. Grandma, I look forward to seeing you each week and being there for you if you need us. Your grandson, Colin.
And now a special song on gratitude.
Thank you.
Please bow your heads for a special Grandparents' Day blessing. Dear Lord, thank you for this day. Thank you for creating our grandparents, who created our parents, who then created us. God, you are so good and have blessed us with amazing grandparents who love us and help care for us. We pray a special blessing over them today, that you keep them safe and healthy and you fill them with joy and peace this holiday season. Thank you that they gave some of their time to be here with us today. We pray all of these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Our final song is a popular American medley. Please sing along with us and enjoy.
What a wonderful day we've had. Let's give the 4th and 5th graders one more hand. All right. Well, I just wanted to say thank you so much again for spending a half day with us, getting to have you be in the classrooms, having you be here in the Performing Arts Center, in the gym, goodies, all the things. It's been a great, great day. We still have, it is now, we're finishing up our day. So whatever plans you've made with your students, you can do that. If you brought coats, we have transferred all of them up to the lobby for you. So you don't need to go back down and get your coats. We'll have it up here for you. We have shuttles running for you so that if you need to get to where you need to go, we still have people with lanyards who can assist you if you have a question, if you aren't sure where to meet people. We're glad to help you still. So one last thing before you leave. On the back of your schedule today was an ad for a play coming up. And some of you heard me say this today, but some of you have not. We have a play coming up in 2 weeks. And the reason we want to invite you is, A, it's an amazing play. It's hilarious. It's a comedy. But two, it's our Performing Arts Center grand opening. We're going to cut the ribbon. We're going to pray. We're going to celebrate God's goodness and celebrate all of the people who helped contribute to make this happen. So we would love for you to be there because many of you are a part of that, and we want to honor you that night. So thank you so much. And yeah, I think that concludes everything. So again, if you have questions, you may ask, but our main lobby's up here if that's easiest for you. You can also still use this floor and use an elevator to get up if you need to. God bless you all, and happy Thanksgiving.